Welcome to Crypto Jargon. In this episode, we break down the terms token swap, token burn, Ether address, and vanity address, all in connection to cryptocurrencies and blockchain technology, of course. So let's start with what is a token swap. First, a reminder about tokens in case you missed the episode where I explained the difference between coins and tokens. These are the cryptocurrencies that are built on top of another platform in the form of smart contracts, and they don't use their own blockchain. They utilize the blockchain of the platform that they were built on, like BAT, Basic Attention Token, or OMISGO, OMG, which are built on the Ethereum platform and they use Ethereum addresses and its blockchain. So in some cases, projects that based their tokens on an existing blockchain decide later on to migrate to their own mainnet blockchain in order to have more options and control over their currency, like it happened to Tron and EOS last year. After the migration, the tokens become separate and can be used as payment units for certain purposes. That token is no longer a token, but it can be considered a coin, and the old version of the token is not compatible with the new version of the token. Therefore, you need to make a swap of those tokens. And usually the swap would be at 1-to-1 ratio, but it could be different. Sometimes you can be rewarded with more tokens of the new token than you had previously, because the total supply might be reduced. Some coins do that in order to create more scarcity and raise the value of their cryptocurrencies. So token swap is literally swapping of the old tokens with new tokens when there is a change migration from a token being based on a different blockchain to the token being based on its own native blockchain. Now the next term is token burn, and this is the destruction of certain number of tokens or coins in order to reduce their number in circulation, in order to create scarcity. On the whole, token burn is a deflationary measure helping to increase the token value and to retain the confidence of the token holders. First of all, this strategy allows reducing the total supply and thus increasing the market value of tokens. Usually when a company burns or locks a number of tokens, it causes the price to increase due to the low of supply and demand. Even just the news about upcoming token burn can significantly drive up the prices on exchanges. Also, this is the way of maintaining stability and minimizing possible fall in the prices. Examples of token burns are Binance Coin and KuCoin shares, both of which have regular token burning, which is public and is publicized in order to maintain transparency. The public record of this process is known as proof of burn and is covered in another episode of Crypto Jargon, which you will find linked in the description of this one. And here comes the next term, Ether address. Well, this is the address used in proof of burn algorithms to store the coins that can never be spent. Ether addresses are valid addresses that were generated randomly and not from a specific private key. Since you cannot backward calculate a private key from a public address, these Ether addresses are basically unspendable. So these are the addresses where tokens are being sent to during the process of token burning. Here is an example of an Ether address and the amount of tokens that were burnt or locked in it. And this is another example. This is an Ether address for Bitcoin, and these are the Bitcoins that were locked in that Ether address. They can never be spent. So make sure that you do not send Bitcoin to that address. Lastly, there is also something called vanity address. It sounds fancy, right? It's actually a Bitcoin wallet address that contains a number of letters that you can choose yourself. Like this one here that I created, and I selected your name followed by the rest of the auto-generated alphanumeric characters. The address also has to begin with the digit or else it will not be associated with the Bitcoin blockchain, so I had to leave that one at the beginning of the address. If you want to create your own vanity address, there is a free service and I will drop the link in the description below, so make sure that you check this out.
Enjoying this content? Go check out Crypto Jargon, the ebook, out now on Kindle. It's an Amazon bestseller and it's the most up-to-date crypto dictionary with more than 700 terms, acronyms and trading slang related to cryptocurrencies and blockchain tech.
Just go to ojjordan.com/cryptojargon and grab your digital copy today.